Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hi, I'm Greg Marcus. I'm the pastor of Approval Life Christian Center. This is our Sunday morning via the internet church service. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you so much for being with us. We really appreciate you being part of our ministry and participating with us and participating with us in this Bible teaching ministry. We thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we're on the prayer of decreeing right now, but specifically we are on this part. Jesus taught his disciples to decree. Jesus taught his disciples to decree. So, you know, this prayer of decreeing that I'm talking about, Jesus taught his disciples to do that. Hallelujah. So let's look at Mark chapter 11, verse 22. And this is Jesus speaking. He says this, have faith in God, or literally it would be have the faith of God, or have God's faith, which is more accurate, actually. Have God's faith, Jesus answered. Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in their heart, but believes that what they say will happen, it will be done for them. Woohoo! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in their heart, but believes that what they say will happen, it will be done for them. That's the prayer of decreeing we're talking about. That's the prayer of decreeing that Jesus taught his disciples. In fact, right here in Mark chapter 11, verse 23, he's teaching his disciples to do his works. And the first thing that I saw when I was studying this scripture, meditating on it, and really concentrating on it, the first thing I saw was that the key to decreeing is faith. You can see that, right? Does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what they believes what they say will happen, it will be done for them. And so as I'm meditating this, I began to change some things. So let me read it to you that way. Have God's faith, Jesus answered. Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, a mountain, it'll work for a mountain. Go throw yourself, and does not doubt in their heart, but believes in their heart, believes in their spirit. Hallelujah. Does not doubt in their heart, but believes in their heart, believes in their spirit. And then I came to see that to believe in their spirit means to know something in your spirit, to perceive something in your spirit, to hear something with your spiritual ears. Hallelujah. To see something with your spiritual eyes, to know something with the mind of your spirit. Hallelujah. Your mind has a spirit. I mean, your spirit has a mind. Your brain has a mind. Your spirit has a mind. Your brain has a mind. To know something with the mind of your spirit, to see something with the mind of your spirit, to see something with the eyes of your spirit, to hear something with the ears of your spirit. Woohoo! To know something with the mind of your spirit, that's what faith is. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So let's read it this way. Have God's faith, Jesus answered. Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in their heart, but believes in their heart, believes in their spirit, knows in their spirit, knows in the mind of their spirit, believes in their heart what? Believes in their spirit what? Knows in their spirit what? That what they say will happen. Hallelujah. They know in their spirit that when they speak these words, it's going to happen. They know that what they're going to speak will happen. They know it begins with knowing in your heart. And they, if I speak this, it's going to, it's going to happen. Hallelujah. That's faith. That's the faith he's talking about. The faith of God. God's faith. Hallelujah. Have God's faith, Jesus answered. Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in their heart, but believes in their heart, believes in their spirit, knows in their spirit, knows what? That what they say will happen, it will be done for them. Hallelujah. It will be done for them. So the key to decreeing is faith. And what is faith? Faith has three parts. Begins with knowing that thing in your heart. Begins with knowing in your heart. And then it begins, and the second part is acting on what you know. In this case, it's speaking to the mountain. Hallelujah. You know in your heart the mountain's going to move. You speak, you act on what you speak to the mountain. Hallelujah. And then the third part is enduring, is waiting on the Lord, is holding fast. How long do I wait on the Lord, Greg? Hallelujah. How long do I wait on the Lord, Greg? How faithful is the Lord? Hallelujah. How long do I wait on the Lord, Greg? How faithful is the Lord? Hallelujah. He's a-coming. It's a-coming. The answer is wait on the Lord. So those are three parts of faith. And then I began to show you specifically that Jesus taught his disciples to decree, to use this prayer of decreeing, to use this prayer of decreeing to minister to people, to do the works of Jesus, to heal the sick, to cast out demons. We saw in Matthew chapter 17, the disciples came to Jesus after they could not cast out a demon. Why couldn't we cast him out? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. They didn't go to the theologian. Why couldn't we cast him out? The theologians would have dreamt up something. They didn't go to the doctrinal experts among the Jewish people. They would have dreamt up some explanation. No, they went to Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When it doesn't work for you, go to Jesus. And what did Jesus say? He said, because of your unbelief. They couldn't cast him out because of their unbelief. But he said that if they had faith as a grain of mustard seed, they'd be able to say to this mountain, be thou plucked up and cast into the sea, or whatever it says. You know, I'm usually quoting from the King James translation. And nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible. Woo! Hallelujah. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall, if you have faith as a grain of mustard, nothing shall be impossible unto you. And so what I wanted you to see from that was, see, he's teaching them to cast out demons out using this speaking to the mountain thing, using this speaking to the mountain by faith thing, using to this thing that I'm calling the prayer of decreeing. And now we're on John chapter 14, and this one's going to take a little bit, because there's a lot of stuff in here that's important for you to understand about how this prayer of decreeing works, and about really kind of understanding what faith is. You need to understand what faith is so you can understand what Jesus is saying here. Hallelujah. So let's go over to John chapter 14. And well, let me read the first parts to you real quick just so you get the context. This is Jesus speaking primarily. He's speaking here. This is the night before he's going to be crucified in the morning. Hallelujah. And he's preparing his disciples. He's apparently, he knows in his spirit what's going to happen. Hallelujah. And he's told his disciples, I'm leaving. This has greatly upset them. Hallelujah. And the rest of the conversation revolves around that. So verse 1, do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? If it didn't have many rooms, I wouldn't have told you that I was going to prepare a place for you. Verse 3, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Verse 8. Philip said, okay, here's where we're starting. Verse 8, Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. In other words, apparently, Philip, open the heavens, let us see him, then we'll know it's all true. We'll know if you could just give us some, you know, some proof, Jesus. If you could just, you know, show us. We're from Missouri, Jesus. You got to show us. Open the heavens. Make God come down here. Let us see him. Hallelujah. But the kingdom of God doesn't work by seeing. The kingdom of God works by faith. Hallelujah. Jesus and Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Verse 9, Jesus answered, don't you know me, Philip? Even after I've been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. People usually take this to be some kind of theological thing talking about the triune God or the Trinity, or how that Jesus is God. But that's not what he's saying. He's saying, what you've seen me, you've seen what the Father is like. You've seen me do stuff, that's what the Father would do if he was here. You've seen me, I'm his representative. I'm doing what he tells me to do. I'm his spokesperson. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You've seen me, you've seen the Father. Hallelujah. If you've seen me, you've seen an accurate representation of the Father. And that should be our goal, the goal of every Christian, that we should be able to say, if you've seen me, you've seen Jesus. If you've seen me, you've seen Jesus. That should be our goal. If you've seen me, you've seen Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus answered, "Don't you know me, Philip? Even after I've been among you for such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'?" Verse 10, here's where we're starting. Verse 10, "Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me?" Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and that the Father is in me? The words I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. Hallelujah. Let's back a little bit. Back up a little bit. Hallelujah. Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? Jesus was in God and God was in Jesus in the same way that we are in God. We are in Jesus and Jesus is in us. Watch, skip down to verse 20 and look what it says. This is Jesus speaking, just a few verses more, 10 verses more. It says this. Well, let's go to verse 19. "Before long, the world will not see me anymore, but you will see me. Because I live, you will also live." Verse 20. "On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father and you are in me and I am in you." Hallelujah, hallelujah. "On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father and you are in me and I am in you." It is like a network, like I like to say. We are connected to Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus is the vine. Jesus is the trunk and we are the branches. We're connected together. Hallelujah. Part of the vine or the trunk is in the branch and part of the branch is in the vine. Hallelujah. Can you see that? Hallelujah. So we're connected. That's how Jesus is talking about how he was connected to God, how he's community. He doesn't mean that God lives like a little man on the inside of him or that he lives like a little man on the inside of God, which is what I kind of used to believe, but he means we're connected like a network. Watch, turn over to John chapter 15 and he continues on this theme. "Remain in me as I also remain in you." Hallelujah. "Remain in me as I also remain in me, you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine." If you have a grapevine and you take one of those branches out of the main vine, you cut the branch, it can't bear fruit. Hallelujah. That's what he's talking about us. Hallelujah. "Remain in me as I also remain in you." The vine and the branch are connected. Hallelujah. "No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me." Verse 5, "I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing." You know, we're separated from him, but we can't do anything. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now go back to John chapter 14, verse 10. Hallelujah. So this same picture that Jesus is using about us and him, that we are in him and that he is in us and that it is only because we're in him that we're able to produce fruit. And if somehow we get separated from him or we separate ourselves from him, we will no longer be able to produce fruit. Just like the branch of the grapevine cannot produce fruit if it's separated from the grapevine. And he's using that same language that he uses to talk about the Father. Verse 10, "Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me?" Hallelujah. They were connected. Hallelujah. We're connected to Jesus. Jesus is connected to us. We're spiritually joined together. Jesus and the Father were spiritually joined together. He means this as a real thing. This isn't just some kind of theological language, but he's talking about I am constantly connected to the Father. The Father is constantly connected to me. I am in constant, you could put it, I am in constant communication with the Father. The Father is in constant communication with me. Hallelujah. Woohoo! Hallelujah. We are connected. We are on a network. We are networked together in the same way that we are connected to Jesus. We are networked together with Jesus, so that we can be, if we don't separate ourselves from him, we can be, and we're supposed to be, in constant communication with him, and he's supposed to be in constant communication with us. We are networked together. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So you can see how he can say, he that has seen me has seen the Father. What I do is only what the Father shows me to do. Hallelujah. Does that make sense to you? And that should be it. We're connected to the vine. The only fruit we can produce is if we're connected to him. The only fruit we're supposed to produce is the fruit that he wants us to produce. Does that make sense? I mean, maybe we disconnect from the vine. Now we go off and we do our own thing and we produce works and ideas and logics and reasonings and theologies and doctrines and whatever. But if they didn't come from being connected to the vine, then they are not the fruit of Jesus. Hallelujah. Does that make sense to you? Hallelujah. 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 Okay, verse 10. Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? Okay, so now they're connected, and I need to show you that because of what part comes next. The words I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. In the King James Bible, it says, I do not speak of myself. In the Revised English Bible, it says this, do you not believe that John chapter 14, verse 10, Revised English Bible. Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? I am not myself the source of the words I speak to you. It is the Father who dwells in me doing his own work. Hallelujah. In the New English Translation, the NET Bible, it says this, do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own initiative, but the Father residing in me performs his miraculous deeds. Verse 10 from the Message Bible, it says this, don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you aren't mere words, I don't just make them up on my own. The Father who resides in me crafts each word into a divine act. Hallelujah! Let me read that one again. I like that one. Don't you believe that I'm in the Father and the Father is me? In me, the words that I speak to you aren't mere words. I don't just make them up on my own. The Father resides in me, crafts each word into a divine act. If he doesn't speak them on his own, where do they come from? They come from the Father. Hallelujah. 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 So go back to verse 10. Hallelujah. What am I trying to say? I'm trying to show you Jesus is teaching his disciples to decree. Hallelujah. Jesus is teaching his disciples to decree. How do you do this decreeing? You got to be in Jesus. That's how the fruit comes. He's got to be in you. You got to remain in him. You got to walk in him. You got to live in him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got to continue having a good connection. Hallelujah. Have you ever been trying to download something from the internet, you know, and you're here and you're in a hurry and it's like, oh, what's happening? Nothing's working. Come on, internet. Oh, no, don't fail me now. And it's not right. Well, our relationship with Jesus can be like that. We are not connected to him. Hallelujah. 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 Maybe we were connected to him in faith at one point. Maybe we were connected to him as far as healing is concerned at one point. Maybe we were connected to him in terms of answered prayer at one point. Maybe we were connected to him in terms of receiving prosperity at one point, but maybe now all we're connected to him is of going to heaven when we die. Hallelujah. And that's the only fruit we're gonna produce is when we die, we'll go to heaven. Woo! God wants us to produce fruit. What is the fruit? Doing the works of Jesus. Healing the sick, casting out demons. Freely you have received, freely give. What is the fruit of Jesus? To do the works of Jesus, to cause the kingdom of God to show up, to cause God's reign to show up in people's lives, to deliver, to rescue, to set free, to preach the gospel to the poor, to open the eyes of the blind, to rescue them that are oppressed. Hallelujah! Those that are beaten down. Hallelujah! That's the fruit that we're supposed to be producing. How are we going to produce that fruit? Oh, Greg, should we come up with some plans for doing this? Should we come? I mean, you do whatever Jesus tells you to do. Hallelujah. I don't have any problem. I'm not telling you. I'm not Jesus. Hallelujah. But one of the main ways you're supposed to be doing that is by decreeing. Decreeing in faith, speaking to the mountains in people's lives in faith. Hallelujah. Speaking to the mountains in people's lives in faith. Speaking to the mountain in people's lives in faith. Well, guess what? If you're not connected to Jesus in the faith thing, hallelujah, you're just connected into Jesus. You just have a good connection to the Go to Heaven When You Die website. That's the only website your computer is connected to. Hallelujah. You never go to the faith website. You never go to the Filled with the Holy Spirit with the Evidence of Speaking in Tongues website. Hallelujah. Then you're not connected to Him in those things. Hallelujah. You never go to the healing website. You never go to the prosperity website. Guess what? You're not connected to Him in those things. Hallelujah. So you just have to do stuff on your own. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Verse 10, John chapter 14, verse 10, and it says this: Don't you believe that I'm in the Father and that the Father is in me? The words I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing His work. Look at these scriptures. Here's what I want you to see from that. I'm probably not making it super clear, so let me make it clear here. Hallelujah. Jesus is telling us here in John chapter 14, verse 10, He said, the words I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority, rather it is the Father living in me who is doing the work. Or in the Message translation, it said, the words that I speak to you aren't mere words. I don't just make them up on my own. The Father resides in me, crafts each word into a divine act. Hallelujah. Here's what He's trying to tell us. Jesus only does what He sees the Father do. Jesus only does what He sees the Father. Seeing what the Father does is faith. Hallelujah. That's one of the definitions of faith. That's one of Greg's definitions of faith. What does it mean to believe? To see with the eyes of your spirit, to know with the mind of your spirit, to hear with the ears of your spirit, to perceive with the eyes of your spirit. Hallelujah. Can you see that? According to me, what is faith? What is the first part of faith? To know something with the mind of your spirit, to see something with the eyes of your spirit, to hear something with the ears of your spirit. Hallelujah. What does Jesus say? Hallelujah. Look here in John chapter 5. He says, the words that I speak to you aren't mere words. It's from the Message translation. The words that I speak to you aren't mere words. I don't just make them up on my own. The Father who resides in me. How does He reside in me? Is there a little God living in Jesus? No, He resides in Him in the same way that the branch resides in the vine. How does the branch reside in the vine? They're connected. There is a connection. There is a network of pieces of the branch, a network of pieces of the vine that connect together, allow the fruit producing good stuff to pass into the branch so the branch can produce fruit. Hallelujah. We are supposed to be connected to God. Hallelujah. How does Jesus do these works? How does Jesus speak the words that the Father gives Him to speak? How does He do this thing? I don't just make them up on my own. The Father resides in me, crafts each word into a divine act. He does it because he is connected to God. I am in Him and He is in me. He's connected. We're supposed to be connected. He tells us in that day, I am in you, I am in the Father. And you are in me, and I am in you. Woo! What more could you need? You're connected to the Jesus. You're connected to the Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Okay. So let me show you from a couple of scriptures. Jesus only does what He sees the Father do. That's what He just finished telling us, right? It says, the words I speak unto you aren't mere words. I don't just make them up on my own. The Father who resides in me, the Father who I'm connected to, crafts each word into a divine act. Hallelujah. So let me read to you from the NIV just to make sure we're on the same page. So here's John chapter 10, John chapter 14, verse 10, and it says this: don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words, now he's making his point, the words I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. Hallelujah. And what's he, why is he saying this? Because Philip had said, Philip had said, show us the Father. Philip had said, show us the Father. Don't you believe that I'm in the Father and is in me? The words I say to you, I don't speak on my own authority. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. Hallelujah. If you've heard me, those are the words of the Father. If you've seen what I do, those are the works of the Father. If you've heard me, those are the words of the Father. If you've seen what I do, those are the works of the Father. That's the result of him living in me and me living in him. I am producing God fruit, is Jesus basically saying. I am producing God fruit because I am in him and he is in me. Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. Hallelujah. I like the King James Bible. It says, they are not my own. Hallelujah. I think it says something like that. The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. So here's what I want you to see. Why do I want you to see? Because this is how we're supposed to operate. Here's what I want. Jesus only does what he sees the Father do. Jesus only does what he sees the Father do. Jesus only says what he hears the Father say. How do we see what the Father does? How do we hear what the Father says? Hallelujah. With that first part of faith. The same way we know the mountain will move. How do we know the mountain will move? Because we know in here. Hallelujah. How does this knowing come in here? Because verse 22, Mark chapter 11, verse 22, we have the faith of God. Hallelujah. 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 Does that make sense to you? Okay, so let me show you a couple scriptures because I'm almost out of time. Jesus only does what he sees the Father do. Look here in John chapter 5, verse 19. Hallelujah. John, the Gospel of John chapter 5, verse 19. We were in John chapter 14. Let's go back to John chapter 5. Verse 19, Jesus gave them this answer. Very truly, I tell you, the Son can do nothing by himself. The Son can do nothing by himself. He can do only what he sees his Father doing. Very truly, I tell you, the Son can do nothing by himself. He can do only what he sees his Father doing. Very truly, I tell you, the Son can do nothing by himself. He can do only what he sees his Father. How does Jesus see his Father doing? Does he go up to heaven? Okay, yeah, I'm seeing it. No, he sees it in here the same way we see things by faith, the same way we know the mind of Christ, the same way we know the mind of the Spirit, the same way that we know the things that are freely given to us of God, the same way that we have God's faith, hallelujah, we know. Hallelujah. We see what the Father will do. We see what the Father will say. Very truly, I tell you, the Son can do nothing by himself. He can only do what he sees the Father doing. Jesus only does what he sees the Father do. Look here in John chapter 12, verse 49. John chapter 12, verse 49. For I did not, this is Jesus speaking, for I did not speak on my own, but the Father who sent me commanded me to say all that I have spoken. I know that his command leads to eternal life. So whatever I say is just what the Father has told me to say. So whatever I say is just what the Father has told me to say. So whatever, that's Jesus. How does he know what the Father has told him to say? Did the Father send him a letter? Did he send him a telegram? Did he call him up, leave a message on his answering machine? Did he text him? Hallelujah. So whatever I say, it's just what the Father has told me to say. How did the Father tell him what to say? Down here. That's faith. When the Father tells you what to say, that's God's faith. When the Father tells you what to say, that's the faith of God. When the Father tells you what to say, that's what you can decree. When the Father tells you what to say, That's what you can decree. When the Father tells you what to say, that's what you can decree. You know, sometimes we get in these situations in life where we, man, I need an answer now. And, you know, we've been pretty much ignoring God for the past, you know, 7 or 8 or 9 or 10 or 12 months or 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. We've been ignoring God. Hallelujah. Not spending any time with God. We're not even sure that the God net still works, you know. And then something bad happens in our life. Something we need God to show up on the scene. We need God to show up. Oh, Pastor Greg says we should decree. We should decree a thing. And so we instantly want to decree. We want to get to decreeing. Let's get to decree. Well, you got to find the website first. Hallelujah. You got to find that connection first. You got to be connected to him. It's only the ones who are connected to him that can produce fruit. Can you see that? And you spent 10 years not being connected to him. You spent the last 6 months being connected to some other channel. Hallelujah. Knucklehead. You spent the last 6 months being connected to some other channel. You spent the last 6 months 24/7 being connected to some other channel. And then when you need God, hallelujah, I don't think that website exists anymore. No, I keep putting it in and I'm not getting anything. What's going to happen, Greg? And so we just start decreeing out of our head. Well, Greg said you could say it. Well, Pastor Papa Hagen said you could say it. Oh, Pastor Price said you could say to that mountain. So I'm going to say to that mountain. And then we go away and say, well, I said, I did exactly what Greg said to do and nothing happened. I did exactly what Greg said to do and I did absolutely exactly what Greg said to do. And you know what happened? Nada. Zilch. Zero. Niet. Nothing. Hallelujah. It's not me. You're not connected to Greg. Hallelujah. Yet Jesus only does what he sees the Father. You're not supposed to do what you see Greg do. You're supposed to see what you see Jesus do. So whatever I say is just what the Father has told me to say. We should be able to say, whatever I say is just what Jesus told me to say. Whatever I say is just what Jesus told me to say. Well, let's say you can't find that. You know, you deleted that bookmark from your computer and now you can't. What was the bookmark for that? I don't have my password for that website. What was our password for that website? What was our password for the Jesus net? Hallelujah. But you need an answer now. Hallelujah. That's why you need to hang out with Christians. You need to hang out with people who know how to pray. You know, you got to hang out with people who know what faith is. You got to hang out with people who can get answers from God. People like Miss Martha and Miss Connie and Miss Nitzia and Becky. Hallelujah. Chrissy. Hallelujah. People who know how to get answers from God. You got to hang out with them. And you call them up and say, I don't know. I've been trying to get on the God net all day, but my computer's not working. Can you please pray for me? That's where the prayer comes in. Hallelujah. That's where other people praying for you comes in. Hallelujah. You may not be able to handle it at the time, but hang out with other Christians. Find other Christians who know how to believe God. Find other Christians who know what faith is. Find other Christians who know how to pray. Find other Christians who know how to believe God. Find other Christians who believe in healing. Find other Christians who believe in prosperity. Find other Christians who believe in answered prayer, and they'll help you. Hallelujah. And then meanwhile, you got to get back. You got to stay in him. You got to abide in him. You got to be living in him. That connection has to be alive. Hallelujah. 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 I'm not finished, but I am out of time. Hallelujah. Jesus taught his disciples to decree, is what I want you to see. What is it we can decree? Only what Jesus tells us to decree. Fortunately, that covers everything. Hallelujah. You may not be able to get access to that page as quick as you want. Hallelujah. But if you'll keep on that page, if you'll keep abiding in him, hallelujah, then he'll tell you what to say in the finances situation. He'll tell you what to say in the job situation. He'll tell you what to say in the healing situation. He'll tell you what to say in your children's situation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And when Jesus tells you what to say, hallelujah, and you say it, hallelujah, what's going to happen? Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Please come back next week because I'm not finished. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for being with us today. If you could, we'd appreciate it if you could do us the favor of hitting, if you enjoyed this program, hit the like, subscribe, notification bell, and leave us a positive comment. Hallelujah. Question, advice. If you have prayer requests, send them to us by email. Hallelujah. If you want to learn more, you can go to our website, www.ivychristiancenter.com. You can also contribute to our ministry there by clicking on the Feed the Ox button, and you'll be able to give a financial donation through PayPal, which will keep this teaching ministry going. Hallelujah. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We really appreciate you guys. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.